safe handling of chlorine dioxide. Chlorine dioxide is a strong oxidizing agent that is often used in various disinfection applications. Chlorine dioxide is a reactive, unstable gas that can decompose spontaneously with a puff of gas expansion that can detonate when levels are above the OSHA PEL of 0.1 parts per million TWA. These explosions can further ignite combustible materials. Chlorine dioxide is incompatible with combustible materials, oxidizable organic vapors, hydrogen sulfide, or metallic dusts. Chlorine dioxide is highly reactive upon contact with these incompatible materials and will decompose upon exposure to sunlight, ultraviolet light, or heat. Decomposition may ignite combustible materials. Equipment manufacturers' recommendations for design, operation, and maintenance of chlorine dioxide generation equipment must be followed. It is necessary to take all precautions to avoid personal contact and to prevent release of gas into the workplace. Always ensure adequate ventilation in handling areas. Chlorine dioxide gas cannot be stored as a pure material. ClO2 solutions require light-proof FRP or polypropylene polyethylene tanks at concentrations below 8 grams per liter. These tanks should be provided with an adequate air sweep to ensure that explosive concentrations of chlorine dioxide do not build up in the headspace. Good ventilation must be maintained so that chlorine dioxide levels are maintained below the PEL at all times. Cartridge-type respirators should never be used for entry into an area with a suspected chlorine dioxide release, as they are intended for escape purposes only. Self-contained breathing apparatus, SCBA, should be used when entering an area where the presence of chlorine dioxide is known to be above OSHA PEL or if suspected. Use of contact lenses is not permitted where a potential to exposure to chlorine dioxide exists. Personnel working in the vicinity of chlorine dioxide gas or solutions should carry a suitable respirator for escape purposes at all times, in case of accidental release of ClO2. When there is potential for direct contact with ClO2, use of a full face shield and chemical safety goggles is mandatory.